Okay, I'm going to look at circular functions, trig functions, exact value. So I have a five-step process to graph, say, cosine of 150 degrees. First step I do is I draw the angle theta. So on my coordinates, I go around 150 degrees. So that's my angle. Next step is graph my reference angle, theta sub r. This is 150, 30 degrees to the axis. There's my reference angle. Step three, create your reference triangle. So I drop in to the x-axis always. Side opposite 30 is 1. Hypotenuse is 2. Side, this is 30, this is 60. This is root 3. Step four is double check negatives. So from here to here, I go over a negative and I go up. Hypotenuse is always positive. And then five is check what function it is. And use SOHCAHTOA to figure out what side you're looking for. SOHCAHTOA. So I have cosine of 150. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So my answer is negative root 3 over 2. So that's how you find exact values. Radians are pretty much the same. I use the same way to do it. Let's take a look at, say, sine of 315. Whoops, I was going to do radians. Let's do another degree problem. Sine of 315, draw my angle theta into the fourth quadrant. So angle's 315. Step two, reference angle 45. Isosceles right, reference triangle, 1, 1, root 2. Step 4, double check negatives. I go over positive. I go down, so this is a negative. Step 5, the function sine is opposite over hypotenuse. I'm going to rationalize that denominator by multiplying it by 1. That gives me negative root 2 over 2. Find the exact value of sine of 315. That's what it is. So if you follow this five-step process, find the angle, the reference angle, the reference triangle, double check negatives, and then look at what function it is, it's a lot less likely to make mistakes. So take a look at another one. Let's take the tangent of 3 pi over 4. Same thing. Draw my angle 3/4 of the way to pi. My reference angle is 45. Reference triangle, 1, 1, root 2. Don't forget the negatives. Tangent is opposite over adjacent, and my solution is negative 1.